My name is Anne-Chloé Destremeau, and this is A Star, a startling tale about radical responsibility. And this star is a little unusual because I'll start by telling you a story about my gremlin. It happened in a study group, which is a space that Clinton and I hold space for weekly, when I was just being in the space and at some point my gremlin started saying, "You should speak more." And immediately after this sentence, another voice came and said, "No, but you don't have to speak all the time." And this other voice said, "No, and anyway, it's not good to always speak, and I have nothing to say." And this other voice right after that says, "No, but you always find something to say. I mean, you're really good at that." And this other voice says, "No, but I don't have always to talk and be in front and be visible. Like, it's not good for me." And then there's a slight pause for about 3 seconds. And immediately my gremlin says, "No, but you should speak more." And then I realized while I was in this debate that I was trying to figure out whether I should speak or not using all these voices in my head, until I got it that it was only gremlin and it was only low drama. And it's something that now I call the gremlin thought machine. That actually the point of the thought machine is that nothing changes. The point of the thought machine is just to go around and around in this emotional circus. So after this experience that I had, I started noticing it in other people in the following days. And the way I've noticed it is, for example, somebody would feel sad and this emotional sadness, and then would have stories, familiar stories, that would make him more sad. And then he would be more sad, and he would start triggering all these stories about that would trigger more sadness. And it'd be this snowballing of emotion, which were just this gremlin machine going around without an actual clarity about what the emotion was about and what the healing could be about. And another version I found of it was somebody who was a man also who started doing this gremlin research, and his gremlin would say, "Oh, see, we're having this survival strategy." And the moment he would discover a survival strategy, the gremlin would just bring another one saying, "But we also do this, and we also do this, and look at here, we also do all this shit." And it'd be this snowballing of thoughts of the gremlin supposedly noticing itself, but actually for the ecstasy of really this emotion of "I'm not okay" or I'm a bad person. And so I've been discovering and being in this research of what is this really, this gremlin thought machine. And what it seems like to me is there's this emotion that comes. We're triggered by an emotional reactivity. And it's like being on this train. The train goes along. And just before this emotion can become conscious for us, there's you get to this why, this why in the road, or this why in the train track. It's a choice point. And if you have the habit of suppressing that emotion, you'll take this road, which is the gremlin thought machine road, where it will just be thoughts and emotion triggered by the gremlin going around and around and being in a form of low drama inside of yourself. And it usually has a lot of arguments and voices and familiar stories, just these familiar stories. And the experiment that I'm doing at the moment, and this is an invitation, is when you notice yourself in this argument inside of your head, and when you're trying to figure out what is the right thing to do or what should you do now, just assume that it's all gremlin. Just assume that you're in this gremlin thought machine and pause. And then energetically backtrack. You're backtracking the whole train, which could be a heavy train, back to this choice point, this why. You're back to this choice point where what is the only thing that's happening is the emotion. You're just having the emotion, no stories, no voices, no arguments, no debate. You go back to this choice point, right at the choice, and instead you bifurc and you choose this other track, which is about making the emotion conscious, whether it's mixed or unmixed, it doesn't matter. You just go on this track, and what it means is you let the emotion rise. You just let the emotion rise. So in my case, for example, I noticed it was a fear that if I am not productive, if I'm not speaking, if I'm not in the action, then I have no value. So that was the underlying fear emotion that triggered this whole gremlin thought machine. And the invitation is at this point to really slow down, to completely slow down and look around. What does it look like? What is this emotion about? And to write it down. You get your beat book at the page of your emotional healing processes, and you just write the emotion and the first information that comes. And that's the gateway for your next emotional healing process. And I really encourage you to do it pretty soon, because probably it could be an hour later or 2 hours later, or even maybe 10 minutes later, you might even find yourself again in this gremlin thought machine of having a debate with yourself, or of being in this snowballing of emotional reactivity, and nothing will change. You cannot change this gremlin food. You cannot take away the gremlin food without actually going through the underlying emotional healing process. So I want to just add something about this, is that for a long time I thought, oh, if I can make a gap between me and this argument, then the argument will go away. If I'm not actually feeding the argument will go away. And what I notice is that it doesn't go away, it just is more unconscious actually for me. I suppress it into unconsciousness. And this is this invitation that I make for you about the gremlin thought machine. Thank you.